This presentation is about the use of yao and xiang in Chinese. Yao and xiang share similarities in meaning, but they also have differences in usage. This presentation is to discuss their similarities and differences. Both are modal verbs used to indicate one's volition. Volition generally refers to one's will, intention, desire, or plan to do something. A modal verb sometimes is called an auxiliary verb. It is always followed by a regular verb. There are a few differences between yao and the xiang as modal verbs. The first one is that yao is stronger than xiang in conveying one's volition. Look at this short dialogue. 我下个月要去中国. I am going to China next month. Or I will go to China next month. Because of yao, we know that I want to go, I plan to go, and the plan for me to go has been made. 是吗? 以后我也想去中国. Is that so? I want to go to China too in the future. 想 shows that I want to go, or I have a desire to go, but no actual plan has been made. Let's look at two different scenarios. Scenario number one. A manager has a lunch appointment with Mr. Li, and he asked his assistant to make arrangement. The manager says,
我要请李先生吃饭, 请你打一个电话问他喜欢吃哪国菜.
I am going to take Mr. Li out to eat. Please call him and ask what kind of food he likes. 要 implies that the lunch plan has been made. They only need to decide on the restaurant. Scenario number two. Xiao Li wants to ask Xiao Zhang's sister out, but first he needs Xiao Zhang's help.
我想请你妹妹吃饭,你可不可以去问她这个周末有没有空?
I would like to invite your sister out to eat. Can you go ask her if she is free this weekend? From this scenario, we know that no definite plan has been made yet. So, Xiao Li uses xiang, not yao. The second difference is xiang makes the speaker sound more polite and subtler than yao. Let's compare two scenarios. Scenario number one, a student wants to ask the teacher some questions. Scenario number two, the teacher wants to ask the student a question. On the surface, these two scenarios are similar, but because of the role of the speaker in each scenario, each of the words yao and xiang is only proper in one scenario. In scenario number one, the student should use xiang to show her intention. She should say,
老师,您现在有空吗? 我想问您几个问题.
In scenario number two, the teacher would use yao because it is a more straightforward word. Politeness is not an issue here.
王大中, 现在我要问你一个问题.
Xiang is more polite and subtler than yao in these situations, although they convey similar meanings. The third difference is xiang can be preceded by a degree adverb, such as 很. But yao cannot. Look at this short dialogue. Person A says,
明天李中请客, 你们去不去?
Tomorrow, Li Zhong is hosting a dinner party. Are you going?
Person B says, 李忠是我的好朋友，我要去。
李忠 is my good friend. I want to go and I will go.
Person C says, 我很想去，可是他没有请我。
I very much want to go, but he did not invite me.
Grammatically, 我很想去 can be 我想去。
But 我要去 can never be 我很要去 no matter how strong your intention is.
Both 要 and 想 can also be regular verbs. This means they can be followed by elements other than a regular verb.
要 can be followed by a noun, whereas 想 cannot.
This rule needs special attention because 想 is sometimes translated as would like, which is an expression that can be followed by a noun in English.
Let's look at this scenario. 小李 has two copies of the novel The Old Man and the Sea, and he is offering one copy to 小高.
小高 says,
你有两本《老人和海》，可不可以给我一本？
And 小李 replies,
没问题 ,no problem. Which one would you like?
What should we put in this blank?
要 or 想?
Because 哪本 is a noun, you can only use 要 here.
想 would not be correct.
要 can be used in the following pattern, 想 cannot. A wants B to do something.
我爸爸要我学中文。
My father wants me to study Chinese.
You should not say, 我爸爸想我学中文。
The negative form for both 要 and 想 should be 不想。
不要 may sound rude, blunt, or childish.
Also, the negative form for 要 plus verb can simply be 不 plus verb. But this usage does not have a strong indication of one's intention or desire.
Let's look at two examples. Example number one.
明天小王请客，他请你了吗？
小王 is hosting a dinner party tomorrow. Did he invite you?
请了。
Yes, he did.
那你要不要去？
Then, do you want to go? The implication is, do you plan to go?
我不想去。因为我不喜欢他女朋友。
I don't want to go because I don't like his girlfriend.
你要不要去?
Are you going?
Meaning, do you plan to go?
我不去,因为我明天要去北京。
I am not going because I am going to Beijing tomorrow.
Now we will look at one final example.
王大中 always makes bad grades in his Chinese class because he never studies. His teacher asks him why he is taking the Chinese class.
你为什么来学中文？
王大中 replies,
因为我爸爸要我学中文，可是我不想学中文，我想学日文。
Because my father wanted me to study Chinese, but I do not want to study Chinese. I want to study Japanese.
The two examples you have just seen show various usages of 要 and 想.
And this concludes the presentation on 要 and 想.